Finally, that was the trigger for the press meet is a lawyer's case, I said. What is lawyer? It is a Shorabuddin Sheikh encounter case, like Israr Jahan encounter case. I think the encounter is a very common in Gujarat, it seems. Therefore, it is a case. Now it is a, if you, in Google, you go Israr Jahan or you go the Shorabuddin Sheikh, you can see the lot of stories about it. The case proceedings and all those things. The Shorabuddin Sheikh encounter case also, Mr. Amit Shah is one of the accused. That was also transferred from Gujarat to Bombay. It was stated in caravan. When it carried first time the story about these lawyers' death. The lawyer was the district judge, CBI district judge, who was conducting the trial in this case. And the caravan carried an article, and caravan also recorded the statements of the family members. Now they stated, we have the recorded version. Why I am saying here also, people could have forgotten about in Annamalai University, when Uday Kumar died, his father said, he is not my son. That is a history. Now, likewise, there is a, we presume, the lawyer's son says, we have no doubt about the death. But he himself and his sister and his father, they gave a statement to caravan, the death is suspicious. It is not a ordinary death. It is a suspected murder, was their contention. In that case, that Shorabuddin Sheikh encounter case was on being transferred to Mumbai, that caravan said, one of the conditions, that is, we are not about the death of Loya. Let it be investigated. Now that is the PIL pending in Supreme Court. There is also PIL in Bombay High Court. One view is when the matter is inquired in Bombay High Court, why are you now inquiring into it? And let there be an impartial inquiry and find out the truth, why he died, what happened to him. He was at Bombay, he went to Nagpur to attend the marriage, where he died. Therefore, the body was handed over in a man, it throws some suspicion according to the family. Then let the matter be inquired into. I am not on that. Caravan made two important revelations. One is the Supreme Court said, it cannot happen like Jayalalitha's case. There cannot be a transfer of judge. The CBI judge shall acquire the matter. There cannot be transfer. When Ujjipat was acquiring the matter, he was a trial judge. He put a condition that in all criminal cases, that is a difference between a criminal case and civil case. In all the criminal case, the accused shall be present in the every hearing, or he should get a permission not to appear on that particular day. One or two occasions court will permit, or one, two or three occasions. That is why when Jayalalitha instituted a defamation case, these people rushed there, Vijayakanth. About 50 cases against Vijayakanth, a criminal case, defamation. That is why the criminal case will be more pressure on a person. If even a false case instituted, apart from although whether it is true or not, the allegations are true, or you have to attend every hearing. And that which person you have to appear. I cannot give you in every hearing a dispensation. Then Ujjipat was transferred. Loya was appointed. Loya also said, two, three occasions after he assumed office, he did not appear. He said, a particular date you should appear. Before that date he died. Yeah, otherwise I will not give. That is what the caravan took the story. After this Loya, another person was appointed. I forgot his name. That is also important. One is why the person was transferred contrary to the Supreme Court order. Number two is, after the new judge took office, you have erroneously printed Amit Shah was acquitted, not acquitted, he was discharged without trial. Here also disproportionate wealth case, some ministers were discharged without trial, then Supreme Court reversed and asked them to face the trial. discharge is an occasion that could happen without trial. Before examining witnesses, the accused can say, read the charges, read the charge sheet, no need for a trial at all for me, and discharge me. Is an argument made based on the papers that was accepted by the new judge within a month, and he was discharged. CBI did not file appeal. That is the issue. I say, could it not be filed? Is the issue. In Jailalita's case, after Kunha, she went to Karnataka High Court, Justice Kumaraswamy delivered. After Kumaraswamy's judgment, they went to Supreme Court. They did not leave it at that. Therefore, it should reach its logical conclusion. But no appeal is filed by the CBI. But by the side wind, I like to tell about Jailalita's case also. When I deal with corruption, I will just make a mention about that that matter. In like I said, a medical scam. Then could you? Therefore, corruption is one of the issues. Don't think there is no corruption in judiciary. I think corruption is pervasive all over the society. In every department, there is corruption. Therefore, judiciary is not an exception. It is not my statement. It is the statement made by Chief Justices. It is available even in Google. I am willing to share. Justice Barucha, Rajinder Kumar wrote an article. Justice Barucha, a Chief Justice. He convicted that earlier in Tansi case, I think, disqualified Jailalita. He dealt with that case. Chief Justice Barucha said, 20% of judiciary are corrupt. I don't know how he arrived at the figure. 20% are corrupt. Justice Verma, Nirbhaya case, he inquired, is a commission. He's a afraid judge. Justice Verma gave a interview to CNN, said 40 years back, not even a district judge was alleged to be corrupt. Now, on the common man's perception, even in Supreme Court, there are corruption. I cannot deny that. It's a statement made by Verma and Justice Kabadia, who was also a Chief Justice. Therefore, only one thing I may say, the degree is less compared to the political class and executive. And that I can say. And also, that is why people still have a regard or expecting something from the court. Number two, I may say, compared to political class, it lost its total credibility. Every third person, MLA or MP, are facing serious criminal charges, including murder, rape, all those charges they are facing are not the judges. This is the some difference between this section of judiciary and the legislature and executive. Now, Ram Mohan Rao, there is a CBI rate, income tax rate, and so many officials, the judges' residence so far not have taken place. To that extent, we can say. But it is not, nobody can say the judiciary is corrupt-free. But I am not saying. That is why I am repeatedly saying, I am reiterating, it is a statement of the Chief Justices. Now let me come to Jailalita. I want to share an important piece of that may be very relevant. Jailalita was prosecuted under Prevention of Corruption Act. Prevention of Corruption Act is attracted only to public servant. Because of Jailalita, suppose I was a judge, I, in collusion with Ramesh, collected some money from your director or somebody else, some teacher, some case. Then Ramesh also will be arrayed as accused along with me. But Ramesh committed some offense, he cannot be charged under Prevention of Corruption Act. He may be charged under, he may be cheating. He tells the people, I will get the order. He can be charged under 420. Prevention of Corruption Act will not come. Public servant should be there. Because of Jailalita, other three persons, Sasikala, Ilavarsi, initially when Subramanya Swami filed a complaint, sought a prosecution, it was only against Jailalita. During investigation, it was found all the poor people committed jointly together, conspired, and did the offense was the story, prosecution story. And Kunra found all the four committed, liable to be punished under Prevention of Corruption Act, punished them for 4 years imprisonment. A1, first accused Jayalalitha, imposed the fine of 100 crores, other each 10 crores. Justice Kumaraswamy did not upset the findings of Kunra. You kindly see, never Kumaraswamy said Kunra is wrong. He did arithmetic. He said law permits, suppose you have rupees 100, for illustration I am telling you, 100 in excess of that it is unaccountable wealth, it is permitted up to 10%. He put a arithmetic, the wealth, now there it is at under prosecution, comes under the 10% limit was his arithmetic. People had a lot of pity, I am not going into that. Therefore, he thought his judgment will be reversed. Otherwise, he could have gone into the facts and record some finding. Then it will be difficult for a judge to record another finding. He did not go into facts, merits. He said that he only did the arithmetic. Then it went to Supreme Court. Matter was heard at length. Orders reserved. 7 months of judgment did not come. Thereafter, judgment pronounced after the death of Jayalalitha. What the Supreme Court said, see, para 542. I just want to put it to you. You consider it. That Supreme Court said, Mr. Acharya also filed a review. Review was dismissed. The Supreme Court said, for Jayalalitha, Kumaraswamy judgment is applicable. For Sasikala and two others, Kunra judgment is applicable. It is not the Supreme Court, that Supreme Court never said Kunra judgment is applicable to four, but Jayalalitha cannot be sent to jail, but 100 crores has to be paid, it can be recovered from her wealth, from Goyas Garden House or some property. It is not the judgment of Supreme Court, that is why the portrait is hanging, because Supreme Court said it is because of her death. So, Kumaraswamy judgment is applicable. I don't know. Like this APS corpus case, after 20 years, people will say, no, sorry, that is what Acharya said. How? You kindly apply Kunra judgment to her also. That was rejected. You kindly see, this is how, I don't want to say it is a judgment of Supreme Court, therefore it is final. That, but it is not infallible. Therefore, with that, history has to tell what is correct. In 1975, Khanna was proved to be incorrect. But later, only the statute is erected. That is why I like to just to mention about Jayalalitha's case only for showing some interest. Now, the far from this, the related, that issue is about the crisis. If the crisis has to be seen, suppose in your institution, suppose 40% of staff are not appointed, then how you run the institution? In higher judiciary, in high courts, 40% of vacancies are not filled, particularly after 2015. It got swelled. The reason is this. There is an ongoing fight between the power at the center, even at the Congress regime, and also continued by the BJP regime. They wanted to appoint, they want to have a supremacy in the appointment of High Court judges. Now, from 1992, particularly after emergency experience, lot of things happened, like this transfer. One Koshal was transferred from Punjab to Chennai during emergency. He said, I am not resigning. Yeah, people, you know, I will come and serve. He was the best judge, one of the best judges in Madras High Court. At that time, was not a lawyer. Now, my seniors, they used to tell Koshal was one of the best judges who was victimized during emergency. Therefore, now, after this 2015, after they came to power, they passed a legislation called the National Judicial Appointment Commission Act by way of an amendment to constitution. This act vest power in the central government regarding appointment of high court judges. Yet hitherto it was done by the collegium of five judges. That was changed, and power is vested with these central, more power is towards the government. That was a challenge there before the Supreme Court. Five judges, except Justice Chellameswar, 4-1, they struck down that, saying it erodes or it is contrary to violating the independence of judiciary. That is a principle enshrined in the basic structure of the Constitution. I am not going into the basic structure. Is the principle propounded by Supreme Court. That means no state, no party in power, even they have absolute majority, total majority, all the 542 is within a party, they cannot amend the Constitution. Taking away the basic structure of the Constitution is a judgment by Supreme Court. Therefore, one of the basic structure is this independence of judiciary. That is what the Supreme Court said. Now, after this 2015, appointments are not made. More than 40% vacancies are not filled. And the Supreme Court, while striking down, they gave a small gap to the government court, or the memorandum of procedure for appointment. That will be done by the central government in consultation with judges. But in preparation of MOP, the central government is not cooperating. Till date it is not finalized, MOP. What they have not achieved in NJSC Act, they want to achieve by MOP. They want to have a veto power. When collegium recommends a name, they want to say no on the famous clause they want to introduce in the national interest. They said they cannot disclose. Yes, it is a part of record now. I am speaking responsibly, I am speaking before you. It is a national interest, which is a collegium is not so far has not agreed. That therefore, this is the issue pending, that 40% vacancies are there. And the earlier Chief Justice, just before earlier, Thakur was a Chief Justice. In public, he cried, I am unable to conduct my the house without the High Court judges. I recommended long back. He publicly cried that the television channels all showed him in the public meeting along with the central ministers. He cried and virtually cried. He was weeping. Yeah, and it was shown repeatedly, the Thakur. And not only High Court judges, so many High Courts, about more than 10, no Chief Justice, regular Chief Justice. Only acting Chief, that is not a practice. Immediately a person is appointed as a regular Chief Justice. For instance, to my knowledge, Tamil Nadu has no Chief Justice for the past 1 year. Entire India, no person is from Tamil Nadu is a Chief Justice. For such a, it is our strength is 75 court judges.